Last time, we took a look at encoders and decoders. Just a simple little device that maps one of many inputs to a numerical output, and vice versa. Today, we're going to look at a somewhat related component called the multiplexer. You're watching episode 7 of Logic Components. Hello and welcome back to Logic Components. Today, we're going to take a look at a multiplexer and a demultiplexer. Now, here's the deal. Let's say now, between two points, you want to actually create some kind of communication path. However, there are many sources between each of these points. For an example of this on a larger scale, imagine an international phone system between two countries. Now, in order for anyone in country X to actually make a call to anyone in country Y, you're gonna have to connect these two countries together somehow. The simple way to do it will be to run a cable from every single person's house in one country to every single person's house in another country. But that wouldn't be very practical, and that's why the concept of multiplexing comes in. So here's how a multiplexer works. You have a whole bunch of inputs. On top of that, you have an additional numerical input as well. Then of course, you have a single output. The idea is this. The value reflected at the output is actually the value from the input chosen by the numerical input to the multiplexer. Here's an example of this in action. Note that I'm keeping all the inputs constant for whatever value I've chosen there, but what I'm doing is I'm actually cycling the input value that is going into the multiplexer. Notice how the output changes depending on which input I've selected. In particular, what we get at the output is the input value I've selected. So now let us look at the counterpart for the multiplexer, the demultiplexer. As you would expect, the operation is exactly inverted. Essentially, you take in one data input as well as one numerical input. Whatever numerical value you supply to the demultiplexer will actually specify which output the input goes to. So you can kind of imagine both the multiplexer and the demultiplexer as some kind of switch that rotates between your different inputs or your different outputs, depending on which component you're looking at. Notice how this actually solves our problem of communications between country X and country Y. All the phone lines from country X needs to go into a multiplexer. What this means is all you need is a single output line which bridges country X and country Y. At the end of country Y, you need a demultiplexer, which will then split out the input to whatever output, you know, the information is supposed to go to. Essentially, the idea is if you were to actually switch the inputs really quickly on both ends, what's going to happen is on the line itself, you're going to have the input chopped up into many little bits. Every little bit actually represents the communication from a different user. When everything gets to the other end, it reaches the demultiplexer, and a numerical input to the demultiplexer is also switching really quickly. This then splits out all the little input bits into output bits that go into different lines. As a result, you sort of reassemble back the original data that you've chopped up. This, of course, is an extremely simplified visualization of one application of a multiplexer-demultiplexer setup. That is also what it's designed for, even though you can actually use it for different kind of operations. But yeah, essentially, that is what a multiplexer and a demultiplexer does. Now, just to add a little more value to this episode, I'm going to show you one other application of a multiplexer that is actually surprisingly useful. In fact, you can use a multiplexer to let a user choose from a set of possible outputs. Let's say I'm trying to create a simple processor that performs math functions. I already have all the math done. This little chip takes in two numbers and outputs the results of addition, multiplication, and subtraction between the two numbers. Chances are, the user only wants the result of one of these operations, and so he has to choose somehow. This is where the multiplexer comes in. In my spec sheet for this chip, I will give the user an additional selector input. If you input 0 to the selector, the operation is an addition. If you input 1, you get a multiplication. And if you input 2, you get a subtraction. But yeah, that is basically all the multiplexer and demultiplexer does. Just think of it as switching between different inputs and switching between different outputs. Well, that pretty much wraps it up for this episode of Logic Components. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, you're watching 0612 TV. Hello, thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, remember that I appreciate every like, favorite, and comment you give me. If you'd like to see more from me in the future, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. And for more updates outside of YouTube, don't forget to follow me on Twitter at 0612TV. Once again, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.